Time to ruin my childhood. Yay. So what's up, y'all? We are about to get into a video about amazing top 10. This is top 10 scary Disney movie theories part 5. Oh, they got other parts. Ooh, I would have to watch those. I love videos like this. So yeah, this would be interesting. So without further ado, y'all, let's hop straight into this video.
Disney movies are far darker than we ever realized. There's gonna be no happy ever after this video. From Scar from The Lion King eating his own brother, to Alice in Wonderland having serious mental health issues. Let's talk about these theories and more only on today's top 10 list. Starting off this countdown, we have Chip. Obviously, Chip from Beauty and the Beast got his name from the chip we see on his teacup. But the reason why he is chipped may be darker than we realized. For this, let's take a look at the movie Alice in Wonderland. If you noticed, at the tea party scene, their tea china has the same pattern as Miss Potts. So what if that is Mrs. Potts and Chip? On top of that, what if Chip got chipped when the Mad Hatter tried to saw a cup of tea in half for half a cup of tea? Meaning, he tried to literally cut a real boy in half. Ouch, that must have really hurt. But also, if this is the case, then it's incredibly dark and twisted. In our ninth spot, we have Tinkerbell. And if you guys are liking this video so far and want to see more videos like this, then make sure to give this video a big thumbs up. So, Tinkerbell is a darker character than we all realized. At the end of the movie Peter Pan, she literally tries to get Wendy killed. We see this dark side of her that we never knew about. But in the Tinkerbell movies, she seems like such a cheerful and kind-hearted fairy. So, what gives? Well, theory goes that one day the entire fairy population was wiped out, except for Tink. She then was living alone until she found Peter. No wonder she's so attached to him, she's all she has left. All her friends and family were wiped out. It gets darker when people suggested that Peter Pan is actually mind-controlling Tink. He has brainwashed her and the Lost Boys. Now, she's his servant for eternity. All I know is that I get really bad vibes from her. Coming in at number 8, we have the real villain. You know who the villain of the Toy Story movies really is? No, it's not Stinky Pete. It's Andy's mom. Yeah, she's the true villain. If you think about it, she's the one that causes all the problems. In the first film, she made the whole you can only bring one toy rule, which made Woody all jealous. In Toy Story 2, she tries to sell Wheezy at a yard sale, leading to Woody trying to save him and getting kidnapped along the way. And in Toy Story 3, she threw the toys out on the curb, and from there they got brought to Sunnyside Daycare, where Lotso Bear tried to burn them all to death. None of this would have happened if Andy's mom just had kept the toys. Yeah. She's at fault for all of this. She's the real villain. Moving on to number seven, we have the Twisted Theory. This theory connects a bunch of Disney movies together. These movies are Tangled, Frozen, The Little Mermaid, and Tarzan. Get ready for this one. It might blow your mind. So the theory starts suggesting that Elsa and Anna's parents died while on their way to Rapunzel's wedding with Eugene. In Frozen, we see Rapunzel and Eugene attending Elsa's coronation. So we know that they are family friends or something. But along the way, their parents got into a shipwreck. The theory continues on claiming that the shipwreck that we see Ariel explore in The Little Mermaid is the one that took their parents' lives. Now, someone else added onto this theory, bringing Tarzan into the mix. So instead of their parents dying in a shipwreck, they believe the ship crashed upon an island. The island that we see in Tarzan. In fact, Elsa's mom was pregnant at the time and gave birth to Tarzan on the island. Meaning Tarzan is the brother of Elsa and Anna. Sadly, as we know from the movie Tarzan, their parents died from a leopard attack. I know, it's a lot of things to take in. But it would be pretty cool if indeed these movies were related to each other. Moving on to number 6, we have Tarzan Mother now. Gothel. There's this crazy theory out there that Meg from Hercules grew up to become Mother Gothel from Tangled. At first, I was not buying this theory at all. But wait until I present you with the evidence. Okay, so for starters, Rapunzel got her magical hair powers from a cosmic event that created a single drop of sunlight which fell from the heavens, and it grew this golden flower. Well, what if that single drop of sunlight occurred when Hercules first fell from Olympus? Now, take a look at Mother Gothel. First off, how does she know about this golden flower, and how does she know the exact song to sing to it? Well, maybe that's because Hercules told her about it, and told her the song to sing to it. Now, let's take a look at the song. The lyrics go as so. Flower, gleam, and glow, let your power shine. Make the clock reverse, bring back what once was mine. What if she is referring to Hercules and not her youth? In Hercules, Hercules gives up his immortality to be with Meg. So when Hercules died, she went on to outlive him. She probably misses him so much and feels guilty. So she's trying to bring him back. Not only that, in another song, Mother Gothel told Rapunzel to be aware of men with pointy teeth. Well, guess what? Hades, who kept her captive, has big pointy teeth. And lastly, one of Meg's famous lines was,
"No
big lug." What other character has said such a thing? Mother Gothel. Mind blown. We're now at our fifth
That's
and halfway
a good
mark
one.
With
I like
the
that
original
one.
Owner. For this one, let's bring it back to Toy Story again. And let's take a look at Andy's evil mom. This theory suggests that Andy's mom was Jessie's original owner, Emily. And from Jessie's super sad flashback scene, we can see just how much Emily hurt her. Now first off, both Andy's mom and Emily look similar in appearance. Then we have the fact that when Andy was a kid, he used to play with Woody while wearing a red cowboy hat. The cowboy hat looks exactly like the one Jessie wears. Andy's hat is just missing the white ribbon, but with age, it probably just fell off, because you can see the spot where it looks like a ribbon used to be. It could be that Andy's mom, aka Emily, used to wear that hat as well when she was young, and she saved it for her son. In fact, when she donated Jessie, you can see the red hat wasn't in the donation box, meaning she did save the hat. On top of that, the dates line up perfectly. Andy was born in 1989, meaning that his mother was probably born somewhere between the late 1950s to early 1960s. Now take a look at things in Emily's room. Her room decorations line up with that time period perfectly. So it may just be that Emily is Andy's mom, the woman that severely broke Jesse's heart. Moving on to number four, we have the psych ward. Let's move on to look at Alice in Wonderland again. That film is filled with quirky characters with loud personalities. Well, this theory is that everything we see in the film is all inside of Alice's mind. Alice is actually a patient in a mental asylum. She's given a variety of antipsychotic drugs, and while on these drugs, that's when she hallucinates about the characters. For example, the White Rabbit is her anxiety disorder. The Mad Hatter is a reflection of her ADHD. And the Queen of Hearts is a reflection of her narcissistic personality disorder. So Alice in Wonderland is actually just one big hallucination. Coming in at number three, we have Cruella de Vil. Turns out that Cruella de Vil is the way that she is because she might indeed be related to a serial killer. Honestly, this has to be my favorite theory out there. So at this one, we have to look at the 100 Dalmatians book written by Dottie Smith. In the book, the original DeVille Manor was once owned by a man that many villagers were terrified of. They used to hear screaming coming from his home late at night, and then they would, and I quote, "began to count their children." Literally, he was a murderer. So now, that might go on to explain Cruella's weird impulses to harm animals. It's because she's a direct descendant from a serial killer. Coming in at number two, we have the devil. Okay, this is a different theory about Cruella de Vil. Or should I say, Cruella devil. This one suggests that she is a direct descendant of the devil. In the original novel, villagers also claim that Cruella's ancestor had a tail and supernatural powers. At one point, the man was seen with blue forked lightning coming from his body. So maybe he was the devil himself, meaning Cruella is related to the devil. Again, this explains why she's so dark and twisted. And in our number one spot, we have the Brother Eater. Now, you may have heard of this next theory because it went viral on TikTok. But basically, it involves Scar and Mufasa from The Lion King. In the movie, an envious Scar kills Mufasa in order to steal the throne. Now, I don't think any of us ever thought about what happened to Mufasa's body. Like, I just thought he was left there to decay or the hyenas got him or something.
Right.
Well, it may just be that Scar ate his own brother. Yeah, I know. I'm horrified too. So according to the TikTok theory, lions sometimes eat other lions as an act of dominance. And we all know that Scar always wanted to be the dominant and more powerful one. Flash forward, in the scene where Zazu is singing to him, we can see Scar playing with an animal skull. Well, upon Googling what a lion's skull looks like, it looks exactly like the skull Scar is playing with. That could literally be Mufasa's skull. So in conclusion, Scar is a sicko, who ate his brother and kept his skull as a souvenir. All right, guys, that's all for today's video. Let me know.
I was totally gonna brush this theory like get the hell out of here. But I did not know that lions did that. Oh, that is the darkest, most creepiest thing ever. Oh my God. What if he ate? Like, I'm just thinking about it in my head. Like, what if that's Mufasa's skull and bones? Because he was cleaning his teeth with them and everything. Oh, that is so dark. I think that has to be my most favorite theory. Because there's like the Dumbo theory. There's the Pinocchio theory. The Pinocchio theory is like really creepy. I'll have to find it and watch it again because that one is like creepy to me. But this Lion King one is so creepy. Ew. All right, y'all, that was my reaction to this video. If you guys enjoyed my reaction, please make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. That just ruined Lion King for me a little bit. And I will see you guys in my next reaction video. Bye.